Hello students, let us start a new session of chapter 11, Thermal Properties of Matter. Now let us understand black body radiation. Here, while the energy is absorbed or released, that releasing energy at specific wavelength at that particular temperature. So while we relate the wavelength of that energy which is emitted out from any substance or body at that specific temperature, which is denoted as a Wien's displacement law, delta that lambda m into t, that would be constant. And that constant value we are having, that is 2.9 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter into Kelvin. Here, while this any energy is released at a specific wavelength, that released energy available in terms of photons, that gives you that photon energy will give you the light signal. And while that light signal is released at a specific wavelength, then a particular color can be visible to us. For example, color of the iron, to which while we are giving temperature, it will be heated, then in a flame, first it is visible as a dull red color, then the color is transit from reddish yellow to the white color. So here, this Wien's law is useful to estimate the surface temperature of celestial bodies like moon, sun and other stars. The light while coming from the moon, it's found that maximum intensity of the light is available at 14 micrometer wavelength. By Wien's law, we can identify the temperature at the surface of the moon that would be equal to around 200 Kelvin. Likewise, from the sun, whatever the solar radiation is available, its maximum intensity is available at wavelength lambda m equal to 4753 angstrom, that we know 1 angstrom equal to 10 to minus 10 meter, that we have referred in chapter 2, that is available at surface temperature of sun 6060 Kelvin. Remember, this temperature is defined at the surface of that planets or sun. This is not defined the interior temperature. So here, black body radiation curves, which is universal, that depends on the temperature. That is not depending on any size, shape or material of that black body. So here, while that energy is transferred by that radiation at longer distance without medium, then it will transfer by that electromagnetic energy in a vacuum. That total electromagnetic energy is radiated by a body at absolute temperature T, which is proportional to size and the ability to radiate, that is known as emissivity, and its temperature. So here, for a body which is a perfect radiator, which emits the energy per unit time, that H equal to A into sigma T raised to 4, where A is the area of the body, T which is in directly contact with the air, and electromagnetic energy radiation takes place by that surface contact. T is the absolute temperature of the body. Now, while this relation actually obtained by Stefan, and then it is theoretically proved by Boltzmann, then that is known as the Stefan-Boltzmann law, whose constant is denoted as a S, which is known as Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Having its SI unit, That is, with its value, that is 5.67 into 10 to the minus 8 volt per meter square Kelvin raised to 4. So here, actually whatever the energy is emitted by that body, that amount of energy is not remain constant throughout, because as the amount of energy is released, temperature will reduce of that body, and the difference of the temperature will change, will again change the amount of heat which is released by that body. So here, actually whatever the heat released by that body, that amount of heat that is for the fraction of the rate is available. For that, the substance like lamp that comes close to limit and it gives you the dimensionless fraction E, which is the emissivity. By placing that value, heat released, that H equal to A into E into sigma into 10 raised to 4. That E is defined the emissivity of heat energy from that body at the particular time instant. For the perfect radiator, E is 1. For the tungsten, E is 0.4. If we take one example, the tungsten lamp at a temperature 300 Kelvin having a surface contact area 0.3 cm square and its emissivity is 0.4. By substituting that values, we can say that tungsten lamp radiates heat at the rate 60 volt. If a body having the temperature T and in the surroundings that is available temperature TS, so amount of heat will emit or absorb, that is depends on the temperature difference. So for that we can define that for perfect radiator the net rate of loss of energy, that is H equal to sigma A T raised to 4 minus T S raised to 4. And by including the emissivity of a body, that becomes H equal to E into sigma into A into T raised to 4 minus T S raised to 4, which estimates the heat radiated. Let us estimate the heat radiated by our bodies, by human body. So let us suppose that the surface area of a person body that is in contact with the surrounding, that is 1.9 meter square. Room temperature, the surrounding temperature, let us take 22 degrees Celsius. Skin temperature, that is a 28 degrees Celsius. And internal body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. But we are always considered the surface body temperature and surrounding region. Internal body temperature we will not consider. So 22 degrees Celsius, while we convert into Kelvin, it will give you 295 Kelvin. And skin temperature 28 degrees Celsius, while we convert into Kelvin, it will give you 301 degree Kelvin. Emissivity of skin, that is a 0.97. So by substituting all the values in heat loss, H equal to sigma into A into E into T raised to 4 minus TS raised to 4. By solving that, we will get the amount of heat loss, that is 26.4 volt. And if we compare it with the internal body 37 degree, then actually the heat produced by our body, that is 120 volt, and heat loss, that is at 66.4 volt. So by comparison we can say that more than half the rate of energy production is lost by our body. So to prevent this heat loss, we supposed to wear a proper clothing with a proper material, which is a thin shiny metallic layer next to the skin, and the heat loss can be prevented. Next, greenhouse effect. Basically, the surface of the earth to which the thermal radiation is available from the sun, and sun will radiate the solar energy, the solar radiation is there, that radiated energy will absorb by the earth surface. So here the wavelength of this radiation lying that is in the range of infrared region. Now, surrounding of the earth we are having the atmosphere, which include the large amount of particles which absorbed this radiation, that infrared wavelength, that are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbon and tropospheric ozone, that is O3. By absorbing that infrared radiation by this molecules, by that particles, the heat in the atmosphere increases, which gives the more energy to the earth, and the surface of the earth becomes warmer, which increase the intensity of radiation from the surfaces. Based on that, the cycle of process described, which is repeated until the radiation is available for the absorption. And based on that, the heating of earth surface and atmosphere, which is known as the greenhouse effect. If the greenhouse effect won't be there, the surface of the earth at the temperature at the earth surface, that would be minus 18 degrees Celsius would be there. But that becomes warmer and the temperature is increases day by day. So here this concentration of greenhouse gases has enhanced due to the human activities to make more pollution, which makes earth more warmer. According to the estimation, the average temperature of the earth has been increased by 0.3 to 0.7 degree since the beginning of this century, and it is estimated that by the middle of the next century, the earth's temperature will be increased by 1 to 3 degrees Celsius or higher than that in comparison to today's temperature. So here this global warming can cause the problem to human life, planets and animals. Because of this global warming, ice are melting faster and sea level is rising. Based on that, weather pattern is changing continuously. Many coastal cities are at the risk. These are submerging in water. This enhanced greenhouse effect may also result in expansion of deserts. So all over the world, the efforts are being made to minimize the effect of this global warming. Right? Is it clear? Here we are going to end the session. With that, we are going to end the chapter. Hope you understood thoroughly. Thank you.